people, welcome back to Politics Watch. Now, it's turned out there's a mini civil war breaking out inside the People's National Party. And you might be wondering why. Well, as you know, the ongoing Petrojam scandal has been a major weapon for the PNP to use and beat Andrew Holness and the JLP. Now, the PNP has been steadfast in saying that Petrojam is, and everyone in the leadership of Petrojam, are corrupt, and you know they're against it, and you know they're for the people. Usual opposition talk. Now, it's turned out that senior, very senior, big man in the PNP, KD Knight, alongside John Junior, who's also another senior member of the PNP, are going to represent the general manager, Floyd Grinley, who was the leader of the Petrojam when all this scandal was breaking out. Floyd Grinley is actually bringing a wrongful dismissal case against the government, right, or against the state-owned oil refinery, in other words, so the government, basically, right? Now, this is very embarrassing for Peter Phillips, and it's embarrassing for the PNP, because when you come out on your moral high horse, so to speak, condemning the JLP and anyone who's associated with Floyd Grinley, and then suddenly the same Floyd Grinley takes the same money that you say is corrupt, goes to two of your most senior politicians, and get them to work on his case. As you can imagine, it did not go down too well. But everybody know KD Knight is a fighter. And apparently KD Knight hit back at the PNP. And he basically brought up some old cases, saying that, you know, in 1980, there was Huntley Monroe, you know, that case was scandalous. KD Knight took it on, right? Some of you might remember when there was the light bulb scandal, right? When nobody wanted anything to do with that case. You know who step up and take on that case as well, right? Yeah, man, that was KD Knight. So KD Knight is not really afraid of these, especially the younger politicians. They cannot intimidate KD Knight. That's impossible. This is the man they call the sheriff, right? KD Knight has been around politics for a very, very long time, right? But really, what KD Knight is saying is that he's a lawyer first. He's a businessman. So if somebody come to him asking for his services and paying for his services, he's going to go. Now, I don't know why the PNP are reacting like this. What do they think? That morals trump money? They know that's not the case. And even the same people who are attacking KD Knight, them know, say, they're not going to miss out on a case like this because of no morals. Right? This is just usual political hypocrisy. Right? People remember back to the Kern Spencer case. Remember, you know, when KD Knight defended Kern Spencer, not only did the JLP attack him, but also PNP attacked him for defending Kern Spencer. Right? That case was one of the biggest corruption cases we've ever seen, and it was KD Knight who stepped up to defend him. So this is not surprising that KD Knight would back up Floyd Grinley. Floyd Grinley has money. He's willing to pay for KD Knight to defend him, and KD Knight take on the case. PNP are just embarrassed because after they've been preaching about morals and ethics, one of their most senior members, or two of their most senior members, are now defending the man they're portraying to be some kind of devil, right? So it's egg on their face, basically. Now, the junior members in the PNP can't touch KD Knight. I don't know how Peter Phillips will deal with this. Apparently KD Knight is saying he's willing to even lose his seat in the Senate, right? But he's not giving up this case, right? So it will be very interesting to see how this one turns out. right? Because you have a man who, based on history, is willing to take on some of the most controversial cases in Jamaica. If you even go way back to 1983, when there was the Immaculate Murder Scandal, right? It was K.D. Knight who defended the man named Shorty, right? Major case, way back in the 80s, right? So, I don't know. How is this one going to turn out? Do you think politicians should put aside morals for money, or do you think at the end of the day this is business and they should defend whoever is paying them? Right? That's what I want to know, right? Because I know K.D. Knight owns a law firm and he's a businessman. All that talk about morals and ethics and all corruption, that's just noise. End of the day, if somebody bring $2-3 million and say, yo, defend me, I'm not gonna take it. Let's be realistic, right? This is just embarrassing for the PNP. It's egg on their face, right? Because now they have the JLP laughing at them because they're painting Floyd Greenley to be the devil. And now two senior members of the PNP are going to be defending the devil, right? So, usual politics, I for us laugh. Anyway, people, tell me what you think about this. You think KD Knight is right to back up or defend Floyd Greenley after all he's paying his money? But do you think KD Knight should have said no, morals first, ethics first? Let me know in the comment section. Big up.